Baptist Church. Good morning, United Vision Baptist Church. Put your hands together if you know it's good to know Jesus. How many of you know Jesus this morning? How many of you know it for the pardoning of your sins and for blessing you, for waking you up this morning, starting you on your way? It's good to know Jesus. I'm in love with Jesus. But that ain't the best part. The best part is that he's in love with me. Right. Amen? Right. Amen? Right. Come on, Johnny. Bring us home.
Heaven is my goal.
Heaven is my goal.
Each and every day.
Every day.
I got to keep on moving.
Stumble all along my way.
If I should stumble,
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Would everyone please rise for the reading of the Lord's word?
Yes, sir.
Come from Romans 5. Therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom also we have access by faith into the grace within we stand, and rejoice hope of the glory of God.
Yes,
and not only so, but we glory
in
tribulation
also,
knowing that tribulation worketh within, worketh patience.
Yes.
And patient experience, and experience hope.
Yes.
And hope make it not ashamed, because the love of God is shed abroad in our heart by the Holy Ghost, which is given unto us.
Yeah.
I read Romans 5, chapter 5, 1 through 5. May the Lord have the blessing in reading of his word.
Praise God. Thank you. Thank you.
Heavenly Father, we come thanking you for this day, realizing that heaven is our goal. Heavenly Father, each and every day.
Yes,
Heavenly Father, don't let us be a stumbling block.
Yes,
have we walked this Christian journey? Father, we thank you right now for another opportunity to come out and praise your holy name. You're worthy of all the praise, Heavenly Father. You're worthy of all the praise. Hallelujah to your name this morning. We thank you, Father, for allowing us to come out one more time. Father, we thank you for our pastor who's continued to lead and guide us, Heavenly Father, in the times that we're living in right now. Hallelujah, Father, to your heart, to your name this morning. Father, we know that every time you turn around, there's something, Heavenly Father, that's going wrong, something that's contrary, Heavenly Father. But help us to hold on, Heavenly Father, because we know that we got victory in you, Heavenly Father. We know that the word says, in the end, we have the victory, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, let us rejoice, Father, that one of these old days, Father, that you're going to fix it by and by. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, stir us up right now in this service right now. Stir us up right now in this service right now. Father, we don't know if this might be our last time, but Father, let us praise your holy name. Touch right now each and every member that's here today, each and every one that's watching, Heavenly Father. Touch right now. Let a song, a prayer, or something, Father, stir them up this morning. We need you right now, Father. We need you right now, Father. We need you right now, Father. Touch your people, Father. We leaning and depending on you, Father. Bless right now. Stir us up right now. Meet us right in the center of our needs right now. Somebody needs you, Father. Somebody needs you as a doctor, a lawyer, a heart fixer, whatever the situation. Thank you right now. We know that you're able, Father. Touch right now. Touch right now. Touch right now. Somebody got surgery facing them. Touch right now. In the name of Jesus, we know that you're able, Father. Touch right now. Strengthen right now. Touch, Rob. Touch, Father. Touch within my family structure, Heavenly Father. We know, Heavenly Father, that you're able right now. Let us know that you'll be, that you'll step in the void, Heavenly Father. That you'll fix it right now. In the name of Jesus, Father. We trusted on you, Father. We trust in you, Heavenly Father. Lift us up where we might be a little down. Stir us up right now, Father. We're going to bless your holy name. We claiming victory right now. We ain't going to wait till the battle is over. We're going to shout right now, because we know that in the end, we got victory in your name. Victory in your name. Victory in your name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to your name this morning, Father. I thank you right now. Continue to mold me and shape me. Make me the man that you would have me to be, Heavenly Father. We thank you right now. Bless you, bless, bless, bless throughout this service, Father. Touch right now and elevate, elevate, elevate right now, and drench us with your Holy Spirit. In the mighty name of Jesus, we ask it all. Amen. Thank you.
Come on, put those hands together. Oh, 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 oh. Yeah. Here we go.
Lord, you are good and your mercy enduring forever.
who you are.
Did anybody come to worship him just because of who he is? No, don't fool me. Did you really come just because of who he is? Not because of the car you got, not because of the house you got, not because of the raise you just got, but I simply worship him for who he is. Let me see. If God don't ever do nothing else for you, how many folks still gonna worship him and bless his name from the very rising of the sun to the going down of the same? I know the name of the Lord is worthy to be praised. Somebody shout, thank you, Jesus. Worship him for who he is. We greet you this morning. Greet you this morning in the mighty, marvelous, matchless name of Jesus, who is the Christ. Honoring God, who's the head of our life. To my big brother, Jesus Christ. To the Holy Spirit, who walks, talks, leads, and guides me. To my friend and sister, Reverend Cherie Madison Emery. To our very fine deacons, mothers, saints, and friends, and each and every one of you, to all of our virtual viewers, we thank you so much for joining us this morning. Won't you help me celebrate our beautiful First Lady this morning? Clap your hands and show some love for Lady Brooklyn this morning. I often say, and will continue to echo the sentiments of the old church, it's another day's journey. And I'm sure enough glad about it. And I wonder, is there anybody else in the room amidst all the stuff that you have going on in your life, amidst all the trials and tribulations, ups and downs, goods and bads, you can just still testify, I'm still glad to see another day. I'm just glad to breathe one more time. I'm glad that I can exhale and inhale. I'm glad that when I laid down last night, it wasn't my last night. I'm glad that I woke up right early this morning. I might not have all the money I got, but I thank God I had enough gas to get to the church. I may not have on what I want to have on, but I thank God I'm not naked. I might not have everybody that I want to have in my corner, but I thank God somebody prayed for me. Is there anybody in this place that can testify he didn't have to let me live, but I'm glad? Somebody shout one more time. You know you ain't been that good since last Sunday. He just gave you another chance. And I wonder, do I got any another chance testimony folk that say I messed up the first time, the second time, the 10th time, and the 20th time, but I thank God that he looked beyond my faults and saw my needs and gave me one more. Come on, Jesus. Hello. I went from the church to Broadway real quick. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank God. Thank God. But don't you see the difference with what light does? I heard the Holy Ghost. Did you see the difference of what happens to light? Y'all ain't having real church. Y'all ain't having real church. The Holy Ghost says when the light is on, you can see better. Y'all ain't saying nothing. The Holy Ghost said when the light is on, you don't get so confused and lost. Well, who is the light? Jesus is the light. Y'all got to excuse me. I'm just churchy, but that light is blessing me. That light is blessing me, because the truth is I couldn't see what was on my paper real good until the light turned on. I thank God for the light. I thank God for the light. I was walking in darkness, but now I'm in the marvelous light. Is it? Okay, y'all don't want to have me. I'm trying not to have church by myself. I really want y'all to go with me, but y'all gonna make me go by myself. If I have to go, I go all by myself. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine all in my home, all on my job, everywhere I go. I ain't gonna make it shine, I'm gonna let it shine. Somebody shout, shine. Hey. Ain't nothing wrong with your husband. Just turn the light on. Ain't nothing wrong with your wife. Just turn the light on. Your child ain't that bad. Just turn the light on. Your job ain't that jacked up. Just turn the light on. Is there anybody in here that just turned the light on and you can testify? I can see clearly now. That light just messed me up. Y'all got to excuse me. That light just, turn that light off. Turn that light off. Who turned that off? Where is it? Let me see the difference. Turn the light off. Which one is it? Sheree, turn that light off. Who turned it on? Not that one. The bottom one. There it is. Now listen, look at this. Look at this. Y'all tell me y'all can't see no difference. Light on, light off. Light on. Turn it on. Okay? Turn it off. Turn it on. Yeah. Turn it off. Yeah. Turn it on. Yeah. Turn it off. See, when you're walking in darkness, you're susceptible to walk into some stuff. And there's some folk in here that then walked into some stuff because your light was off. Turn the light on. But when I turn the light on, I can see how to get around that thing. Y'all ain't saying nothing. The reason you still in the same stuff you in, turn that light off. The reason you in the same stuff you in is because you trying to walk in darkness and see. You can't see in the dark. But when you turn the light on, I can... I need the light. All right, come on. Williamson says, shine on me. Let the light from the lighthouse. I got to go. Sister Crowell, the Bible says, what good is the light if you're going to hide it under the bushel? But the light ought to be put on a candlestick so that you can see it above. Y'all, okay. What good is a lighthouse if the light ain't on? The church ought to be the lighthouse for those who are in darkness. Every person on the north end of Toledo that's walking in darkness should be able to see when they come close to the church. It's a sad church that ain't got no light. I'm going to say it again. It's a sad church that ain't got no light. It's a sad church that folk can come in depressed and leave out depressed. It's a sad church that folk come in frustrated and leave out frustrated. You got some light. There ought to be some changes. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for joining us this morning. Thank you for joining us this morning. We welcome you to the United Vision Baptist Church. where we don't have no problem. We don't. Y'all see, they trying to make me misbehave. Can anybody remember when you was walking in darkness? No, don't fool me. I'm getting ready to go for real. But can you remember when you was walking in darkness and you couldn't really see which way to go and you was trying to walk on what you thought you might have saw the last time the light was on, but then when the light came on, you was able to see what you couldn't see before? Is there anybody in here that can testify? I thank God for the light that shines on me. We're praying and continually praying for each and every one of you, whether you are here in person in the sanctuary, whether you are in the cyber sanctuary, we're praying for you, continuing to pray for all of those individuals who are being affected one way or another by COVID-19. We thank you again for joining us each and every Sunday here at the United Vision Baptist Church. Let me say thank you. Last Sunday, we celebrated our 10th church anniversary. We had an amazing time in worship last week, and we remember that we are a tough church standing in tough times. Thank you all for all of your support and your contributions to our United Vision Day. We're grateful for that. We are in the midst of what we call voting season. Voting season, if you have not already voted, if you have not already voted, please, ma'am, please, sir, hurry up. Hurry up and get to the election the place to vote so that you can cast your ballot in this election. Yesterday and today, we'll be taking part in Souls to the Polls, where we're encouraging churches, barbershops, beauty shops, fraternities and sororities to push all of their people in their organizations to the polls. So if you have not gone United Vision, please make your way downtown to 1301 Monroe Street and get your vote in. Amen. Voting, we are 9 days away, single digits. We're 9 days away. So if you have not had an opportunity, please do so. To our virtual viewers, I don't know where you are, but please find your local polling location or early vote center and make sure that you get your vote in. If you got absentee ballots, don't mail them. Don't even mail them. If you got one, take it down there and put it in the box yourself. Amen. Take it down there and put it in the box yourself. We want to make sure that your vote is indeed counted. This upcoming Wednesday, we will have our trunk or treat right here at United Vision Baptist Church. Right here, United Vision, at 6 o'clock, we will begin our trunk or treat here on the premises, on the campus of the United Vision Baptist Church. We've got all kind of trunks, all kind of candy. Come on out, bring your kids, get you a few little pieces of candy in a safe place. We will have all of our COVID-19 guidelines in place even during our trunk or treat, but we will still want to make sure there's something special for our young people. So come on out to all of those individuals here at United Vision who have signed up to give us your trunk or to use your trunk. Our team is asking that you are here by 5:30. Is that what it is? 5:30, so that we can get you in position and get everybody in their right spot so that right at 6 o'clock we can begin and do what we got to do and get on up out of here. Amen? If you have candy, we still will take your candy that we may be a blessing to our young people. Please see Sister Adrian. Adrian, give us another wave. Sister Adrian, Sister Alexis is not here today, but you can see Miss Adrian giving your candy. Or if you want to give a cash donation, I'm certain that Adrian will go to the store and get the candy for you. So if you don't have the candy today, you forgot it, it's cool. Give her a couple dollars so that she can go get the candy and have it ready for our young people on Wednesday night. Amen? Just want to put on your radar real quick. Thankful Thursdays. Thankful Thursdays is something we've been doing around here at United Vision for the last couple of years in the month of November. And we'll still continue those. They will be virtual. All of our virtual Thankful Thursdays will begin the first Thursday of November. You can catch us right here on our Facebook page. I got some of my friends and my buddies that can and will preach from across the state of Ohio. You don't want to miss these Thankful Thursday services, so make ready yourself to receive those. And last but not least, thank you for all of your giving and your contributions over the last couple of months. We greatly appreciate that, what you have done, and we pray that you will continue to be a blessing to us so that we can continue to be a blessing to not only the body of Christ, but to those that we come into contact with. We love you, we thank God for you, and we pray God's greatest blessings over your life. God bless you.
Ah! Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Everything works together for the good of them who love the Lord. Do I have a witness in the sanctuary that everything works together for the good of those who love the Lord? Amen. You're moving. We see you moving. Everything works.
Everything works together.
Everything.
Everything works together.
Everything.
Everything works together.
For
the good who loves the Lord.
Everything.
Everything works.
Tomorrow,
my God,
'cause I know who I am.
your hands if you know everything is working for your good. If you know it's working for your good, clap your hands and bless his name in this place. Everything works together for the good of them who love the Lord and who are called according to his purpose. If you know you've been called according to his purpose, why don't you open your mouth and bless his name in this place? We certainly thank and praise God for another opportunity. We thank God for our music ministry. Thank God for each and every one of you. There is a word this morning from the Lord. There is a word from the Lord that can be found in the book of Psalms, Psalm number 37. Psalm number 37. Psalm number 37. Just one verse there, verse number 25. Psalm 37, verse 25, familiar passage. I'm sure you've heard it at least once or twice. Scripture says, I've been young and now I'm old, yet I have not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his descendants or his seed begging for bread. Again, I was young, but now I'm old, yet I have not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging for bread. If I can, just for a few moments, speak from the subject, the one thing I've never seen. The one thing I've never seen. Let's pray. God, our Father, we love you. We honor you. We thank you for this moment of preaching. Now, oh God, we pray that you would decrease me so that you may get the increase. None of me, God, but all of you. Let this spiritual food be nourishment to our spiritual bodies. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 The one thing I've never seen. The question becomes, if you were ever to get in serious trouble, is there anybody that you could call on that you know without hesitation or reservation that would come to your rescue? Of all the friends and acquaintances, all the people you hang out with, all the people on your Facebook friends list, how many of them are among the people that you can really call on or count on? The Muscular Dystrophy Association used to do a fundraiser in which they would have people and they would place them in a makeshift jail cell. And they would have them call their friends and ask their friends to donate to the foundation in order to get them out of jail. But there have been some strange responses when folk called. There were some folk who, without any question, just said, what's the number? I'll pay to get you out. But then there are some folks that they called that had to ask a whole line of questions in regards to why you have the need. Brothers and sisters, I need folks in my life and in my corner that I can call on. And when they hear that I have a need, they don't have time to ask a whole bunch of questions. They're just standing ready to meet the need. Brothers and sisters, the truth is, everyone likes to belong to the circle. There's a group who will help first and ask questions later. No one wants to feel like they are abandoned or left behind in times of trouble. I believe persons who have been in the military would know that what they have called a soldier's creed. The soldier's creed, part of it says, I will never accept defeat. I will never quit. And I will never leave a fallen comrade. This assurance that you won't be left alone to face life's struggle is the reason why you and I trust God the way we do. Psalm 27 and 10 says that when my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. He won't leave you or forsake you. Believers have a consolation knowing that as long as we live, the Lord will never leave us alone. There may be times when circumstances make us feel like the Lone Ranger, but we should never despair. There may be times when you feel like you're standing all alone, fighting a cause, or running a race, or running a home, or raising a child, or living every day. But for the believer, we are never by ourselves. The voice of the Savior may not be heard with ears, but the voice of the Savior can always be heard on the heart of the believer. I can hear the Lord say, I will always be with you, even until the ends of the world. And so if you feel a little down today, cheer up, because you're not alone. If you feel like you got a touch or a little bit of loneliness, cheer up, because you're not alone in this race. As Christians, we should remember that as long as there is time and or eternity, the Lord will never forsake the righteous or leave them alone. Which is why I can testify that there is one thing that I've never seen, and that one thing is that the righteous have been forsaken. This text this morning looks at David, and as David is explaining the relationship between the believer and God. The intent of David writing this psalm was to reassure the believer that their faith is safe in God's hands. But also the text reminds us that we ought not be envious of the unrighteous because of their apparent success. And let me pause here. Truth is, you and I see people who do less than we do, but got more than we got. Y'all ain't gonna be real. While you struggling to pay your tithes and all your bills, it's folk who ain't paying no tithes and ain't struggling at all. And you wonder, how is it that they do it all right? And I'm trying to do your will and I'm struggling. Don't leave me in here by myself today. You can testify that you're trying your best to live holy, to live saved and sanctified. But then every time you look around, those folk of the world is always flourishing and seeming to have no problems on their own. The truth of the matter is, it's just an apparent success. It's what we might want to call a spiritual optical illusion. Because the truth of the matter is, and I don't know who like me, I would rather struggle down here and have eternal life on the other side than to live good here and burn up hell when I leave here. Believers are secure with God. The righteous should never or will never be abandoned. In the course of his entire life, David was able to look back retrospectively and he was able to declare, I've never seen the righteous forsaken or their seed begging bread. Who then are the righteous? In the Old Testament, the righteous were those folk who obeyed God's commandments. But in the New Testament church that we're in now, the righteous are those folk who were once sinners, but have been redeemed in spite of their sins and made perfect by the blood of the Lamb. The righteous are those folk who have been saved and redeemed by the Lord. And the Bible says that not only do they're the righteous, but even the seed of the righteous, which means their offspring and their descendants. The Lord generally blesses a righteous family. This is the family that has learned to love and respect God and obey his commandments and serve him faithfully. Those folk will never beg for bread. Brothers and sisters, when a soldier signs up to go into the army, to go into battle, he or she understands that there's a possibility of injury. Yet, regardless of those circumstances, they know that there is somebody or somebodies who's looking out for them. And I wonder if anybody can testify that you knew going into this thing that every day wasn't going to be sunshine, but you signed up anyway because you believed that God would carry you through the storm. I believe that's what James Cleveland said, that he said, I don't feel no ways tired. I've come too far from where I started from. Nobody told me the road was going to be easy, but I don't believe he's brought me this far to leave me. The reason, brothers and sisters, that I've never seen the righteous forsaken is because of three things, and I'm going to rush through so I can get you out of here. The first reason the righteous will never beg bread or be forsaken is because righteous folk got God's promises. God promises every believer that he will never leave them nor forsake them. I believe it was in Genesis, somewhere around chapter 28, where he says, I am with thee. I will keep thee in all places whether you go, and I will bring you again to this land. For I will not leave thee until I have done that which I have spoken of thee. And somebody should have got excited, because the text tells me he ain't going to leave me till he done. I thank God that he won't push me out there and leave me to dry like some of y'all cousins do sometimes. You know, folk will set you up and then get you out there and make you look like a fool and turn their back on you and point it to. So that ain't happened to you. It's just been me. It's just been me. Okay, I'm sorry. That was my own personal testimony. But I thank God that he never leaves me nor forsake me. The promise that was made to Jacob in Genesis 28 is still speaking to you and I today. It's personal. It's clear. I am with you. And I don't know if anybody can testify, but the God that we serve is a promise keeper. And if he promised to be with you, you don't have to ever worry about him turning his back on you. It's important for every believer to remember that as we step in to each day with nothing except for a plan and God's promises, we stepping in to good news. Brothers and sisters, depending upon the promises that God's made, some folk will change their job. Some folk will change relationship. Some folk will lose some of the things they've had attachments to solely based on the promises of God. And I don't know how you feel, but I get excited when I think about God has made me some promises. And listen, if the promise that he made has not come to pass yet, don't get weary, because he's not going to break his promise to you. His word will never come back to him void. So if God spoke it over your life, you can hang on and hold on to the fact that it's going to show up. Old church said, he may not come when you want him, but you sure going to want him when he come. The truth of the matter is, every time God showed up for me, he showed up right in the nick of time. Every promise that he made to me came to pass right in the nick of time. It wasn't when I thought it should have came. It wasn't when I hoped it came. It came right in the nick of time. And I wonder, is there anybody in the church today that can testify, although I wanted it then, when it showed up, it was the right time? The reason the righteous is never forsaken or they never beg for bread is because they have God's promise. But secondly, they have God, a God who provides for them. David said all of his life he had never seen the righteous or their offspring beg for bread. Now this, y'all ain't gonna like this, but let me say it the right way. On the surface, you and I read that text to believe that the believer and the believer's children never have any reason to have a need. But the truth of the matter is, that's not what that really means. The reason David said that the righteous are never forsaken and the seed never begs bread is because David understood the importance of a godly and righteous family. Y'all gonna catch it in a second. Because when I'm a godly and righteous family, there are some things and some principles that I instill in my children that stick with them all of their lives. Truth of the matter is, if I leave my kids some money, if they ain't ready, they're going to spend it before it's too early. But if I put the right tools in them, what tools? You talking about, Harris? If you teach your children the importance of working, teach them how important it is to save and invest and trust and obey God, they'll never have to beg because they got what they need. Brothers and sisters, we've got to teach our children to not beg. Brothers and sisters, testimony is, the preacher's family is always part of the sermon. The lucky person this week is Scotty. Got a little job, making a few dollars. And Scotty thought that when he got his check, it was turn up Tuesdays. And so I let Scotty be great for a few weeks. He spent his little money. Next thing I know, he had new hairstyle. He had boxes coming from Amazon. He had DoorDash coming 3 or 4 times a week. He was eating the best he ever ate in his life. And after a couple checks came through, I said, hey, bro, let me holler at you. It's some stuff you got to do if you want to be successful. And so starting the next paycheck, you're going to have to put some money in church. Because you ain't going to have no job and not tithe in my house and bring a curse on my place. You ain't saying nothing. See, let me see. Y'all don't understand. When you don't tithe, when God has given you a job, you put a curse on your. I'm not saying nothing that ain't right. When God gives you the wherewithal to work your 30, your 20, your 15, or your 60 hours a week, if you don't give him what's due to him, you put a curse on your own life. It's tight, but it's right, and say amen anyhow. So I'm not going to let nobody that's working not pay God, and I got to deal with the consequences. I said, Scott, you got to pay some money to the church. Secondly, I said, we're going to have to cut that DoorDash out so much and put some money in a savings account. A what? We ain't finna spend no whole check and not put no money in no savings account. Now, I'm not saying put your whole check in there, but you ought to get in the habit of every time you get paid, God get paid, and you get paid on the low. Scotty learned the principle real quick. And listen, this is my family. Y'all work y'all family how y'all work y'all family. I told Scotty, when you put money in the savings, when your money run out, you got some place to go if you really need something. So you got to learn how to teach children, and I ain't talking to nobody because y'all got kids already. Y'all got to help me. You got to learn how to teach children at an early age how the stuff works. So Scotty said to me, hey, Dad, I want to go over to Sakura and get something to eat with some of my friends, but I ain't got no money. Can I borrow $20? I said, you can't borrow $20 from me. But since you have a savings, what happens with a savings is when you don't have any other places to go, you go to your savings. Now, again, some of y'all may say he shouldn't be using his money to go to Sakura. He only 17. He ain't paying rent yet, okay? We teach the principles at the age in which they can receive them. Some of y'all mad at Scotty, but y'all ain't got no savings either. Y'all ain't saying nothing. The reason, y'all, I'm sorry, was that out loud? The reason, I'm sorry, I apologize. The reason that my seed won't beg for bread is because he gonna prepare for bread when he got some bread. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Yes, I want Scotty and my children to be in the fear of God, and I want them to understand that God shall supply all my needs, and I want them to understand that faith without works is dead, but I also want you to understand when you got some money, you got to learn how to save some money, because it's going to be a day you ain't got no money and need some money. Don't y'all get super spiritual and think that just because you come to church, he going to supply when you didn't have opportunity to supply for yourself. Y'all don't believe me? I can use the Bible if y'all don't mind. Y'all remember the prodigal son? He was in a good spot. He said, Daddy, give me my stuff now. He took all the stuff he had and didn't do nothing with it except for what he wanted to do with it. And so how is he begging for bread? Because when you don't do what you're supposed to do, when you got what you got, when you don't have nothing, you ain't going to get nothing. He woke up and found himself slopping some pigs. Yeah. Brothers and sisters, you beg for bread, not just because of God, but you also have to beg bread if you don't take the necessary steps to provide for yourself. God provides for you, but you have to understand that he provides for you in various ways. All right, y'all don't like that. Let me get out of there. He says, I've got God's promises. Secondly, I got a God who provides. But finally, the reason there's one thing I've never seen is because God's always got his eye on the righteous folks. Psalm 121 says, he that keepeth Israel neither slumbers nor sleep. In Psalms, it says the eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous and his ears are open to their cry. The promise of God is that he'll never leave us or forsake us. But like soldiers, he doesn't promise that there'd never be injury. He didn't promise that there wouldn't be hardships and trials. He didn't promise that there wouldn't be bullets fired our way. But I believe it says no weapon formed against us shall be able to prosper. He does not promise that you won't be wounded or hurt, but he promises that he'll never leave you nor forsake you. Every believer is in a battle against evil every day. Satan attacks our money, our health, our peace. But we have the assurance that we're not fighting in this battle by ourselves. Blessed assurance. Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. I'm heir of salvation, purchased of God, born of his spirit, washed in his blood. It's this assurance that we have that prompted the old church to sing a song that says, I'm on the battlefield fighting for my Lord. And I promised him that I would serve him until I die. Brothers and sisters, we must remember that despite the difficulties of the moment that we're in, we can make it through if we learn how to hold to God's unchanging hands. If you notice, Psalm 37, verses 23 and 24 says that the steps of a good man are ordered. They're ordered by the Lord. And he delights in his way. Though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down, because the Lord upholds him with his hand. In no uncertain terms, he says that I am with thee and I'll never forsake thee. And if you are like most believers, there are times when you find yourself slipping down in the mountain of life. And you have to say, Lord, hold my hand while I run this race. Lord, hold my hand when I can't see my way. Lord, hold my hand when I can't turn to the right or the left. Lord, hold my hand when I'm confused and don't know what to do. Lord, hold my hand when I'm weak and I run out of strength. Lord, hold my hand when I've fallen and can't get my feet together. And just when I'm about to give up, I hear the voice of the Savior say, I'll never leave you and I'll never forsake you. I'm never alone, which means there's not a cross I'm not able to bear. There's no mountain I'm unable to climb. There's no enemy I won't be able to defeat. There's no battle I can't endure. There's no darkness that can keep me from seeing the light. Is there anybody in here that can testify? I've seen a lot of things, but one thing I've never seen is the righteous forsaken or his seed begging bread. Let's go, y'all. I've been here long enough. I've seen the doctor throw up his hands and walk out the room, but I've never seen the righteous. I've seen family and friends turn their backs on folks, but I've never seen the righteous. I've seen an orange sun and meteor showers and even a crescent moon, but I've never seen the righteous. I've seen business and organizations fold up and crumble, but I've never seen the righteous. I've seen gas prices rocket, but I've never seen the righteous. I've seen a black president in the White House, but I've never seen the righteous. I've seen 45 and all his foolishness for the past 4 years, but I've never seen the righteous forsaken. But that doesn't mean that I'll always win, but it does mean I'll never be alone. We might be beaten, but we're not forsaken. Might be oppressed, but not forsaken. Might be imprisoned, but not forsaken. Might be rejected, but not forsaken. Might be despised, but not forsaken. Might be hungry, but not forsaken. Might be poor, but not forsaken. I might be single, but not forsaken. I might be sick, but I'm not forsaken. I might be hated on, but I'm not forsaken. Is there anybody in the place today that can testify just like me? I was young, but now I'm getting older, and I've never seen the righteous, never forsaken, nor his seed begging for bread. Do me a favor, if you're not too mean, Look over at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I've seen the lightning and I've heard the thunder, but the one thing that I've never seen is the righteous forsaken. Do me a favor, if you can testify that he's never left you, if you can testify that he's never forsaken you, if you can testify you've never begged for bread, jump up on your feet and holler back at your boy and testify that I've never seen the righteous forsaken nor his seed begging bread. I've got good news. If you live right, God will take care of you. Oh, shucks, y'all. Beneath his wings of love abide. Somebody say, God will take care of you. Money can be funny. Change can be strange. Credit can get it. But my God shall supply all of my needs. Say yes. Has the Lord ever made a way? Has the Lord ever brought you out? Has the Lord ever turned it around? Do me one favor. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, come on. Say, let's go. Say, where are we going? We're going higher. Somebody ought to praise God, because God never left you. God never let you down. God always showed up. God always stepped in. Say it. 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 I thank God that all of my needs he has provided. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, God has provided. Say yes, say yes, say yes. Seen it, and here is the shout, I ain't gonna ever see it, because God is gonna take care of me. Is there anybody that can throw up your hands and say, God will take care of me? Say, God will provide for me. Say, God will make a way for me. Say, God will open doors for me. God will heal my body. Say, God will bless my child. God will fix it for me. Say yes. Say yes. Say yes. Thank you. y'all act like y'all tried it before. Y'all act like y'all tried it before. Oh! Oh! Put your foot on it. Let go. Oh. 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 If you tried it and you know, say oh. Oh. I wonder if you got one praise in you. Oh, if you got one praise in you, hit the ground and give it to him. She's still dancing back there. She's still dancing. She's still dancing. Hey! Don't let her dance by herself. At least clap your hands. At least. This shot right here is because he didn't leave me when everybody else walked away. But he. I'm not sure how old David was at the time of the text, but David said, I was young and now I'm old, but I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging for bread. Brothers and sisters, as long as you live, the righteous will never be forsaken, nor the seed will ever bear bread. Come on, clap your hands all over the building and bless his name. There may be someone here today, maybe someone here today, standing all over the building, who wants to know Jesus, who wants to get access to that one thing and never have to worry about it again. When you accept Jesus Christ and you begin to live in a righteous lifestyle, you can rest assured. Come on, say, there's nothing better. There's nothing better. You can rest assured that you'll never be forsaken.
Jesus.
He'll pick you up.
He will pick you up.
Come today. Come on, clap your hands. She's coming.
Around.
Clap your hands.
You want to know him.
You want to know him.
Get to know him.
Get to know him.
Right now.
Is there another today? Is there another? There's nothing?
There's nothing better.
I wouldn't wait another day. I wouldn't wait another day.
Then knowing Jesus.
He gets sweeter as the days go by.
He gets sweeter as the days go by.
You ought to know him.
You ought to know him.
Y'all sound good. Get to know him.
Get to know him.
Right now, today.
Right now, today. Just come.
Wherever you are, wherever you are. Say, come on.
Come on, come on, come on.
Come on.
Come on, come on, come on.
Right now.
Right now, today. Just come.
Come on, let's run it one more time. Come on, run it one more time. Say, come on.
Come on, come on, come on.
Come on,
come on, come on, come on.
Right now.
Right now. Today.
Say, right now.
Right now. Today.
No. Say, right now.
Right now.
Right now.
Right now.
Right now.
Right now.
We are grateful what the Lord has done in this place. We don't need secretary to come today. I noticed this one here. Stand up for me. United Vision, won't you meet Sister Kiana Massey? Come on, clap your hands. Sister Kiana has been hanging out with us for a long time. Kiana's brother is Juwan in the music ministry. That's her brother over there. And Juwan joined up with us a while ago. And he's been dragging Kiana with him every time. And I said, well, when she get ready, she'll make the move. And so we're so grateful today she decided to make the move. And we're simply are elated to have you as a part of our family. You know how we get down around here. So find your place, get in it, and get down with the rest of us. We have great expectation, and we believe God is going to do something great in your life. And we're excited that we're able to sit on the front row and watch what God does in your life. Come on, clap your hands one more time for Sister Kiana. Come on, one more time, celebrate. We thank God for what he has done in our lives. Thank you. Thank you to all of you who are with us. Thank you to all of our virtual viewers. I love y'all a whole bunch. That's my dog. No, again, thank you so much. One thing real quick. We have been starting service at 11:15 every Sunday morning just because we were transitioning back to the sanctuary and we wanted to make sure that everything kind of got in a routine. We are now back in our routine. So we will go back to starting service at 11 a.m. starting next Sunday, okay? So Sunday school will start at 9:30. Come on out for Sunday school. Sunday school will wrap up around 10:40, which will then give us a few moments to get everybody in here, to get all of our stuff set up, and then we should be ready to go right at 11:03 at the latest, amen? Thank you so much for your patience as we've been making this transition. But as we promised, all of this would be happening for us in phases, and so we're going to move to the 11 o'clock hour as a part of our next phase. Continue to join us virtually if that's where you prefer to do that. We'll continue to record and all that kind of stuff. And as soon as you are ready to make your way back to the church, we're super ready to have you to come back with us. Amen? Amen. Also, we're getting ready to go. We can stand, but as we're getting ready to go, we want to send a special happy birthday shout out to Mr. Lee Carter, who is has turned 75 years old today. Mr. Carter, we love you. He's not here today. But let's do this one time for Mr. Carter. Trina, make sure you show it to him. I'm singing happy to you. singing happy birthday to you, too. Y'all know he looked good, always looking fine, and we're glad. We're singing happy, happy, happy birthday to you. Come on, stand up over your feet. Stand up on your feet, we get ready to go home. Well, we're singing happy to you. Ooh. We're singing happy to Lee Carter too. Ooh. If he was here, he'd look good. He would look fine. And we're glad, and we're glad your friend. We're singing happy, happy, happy. We're singing happy, happy, happy. To you, to. Now unto him who's able to keep us from falling and present us faultless before his presence with exceeding joy. To the only wise God be glory, power, and dominion henceforth, now, and forevermore. Somebody shout amen and amen. Our ushers are in position to escort you out of our sanctuary. Please follow the directions of the ushers from the rear. You look good. You look good. You look fine. And we're glad. We're singing happy. Sing it up there. We're singing happy. Woo! We're singing happy. Woo! We're singing happy. We're singing happy. To you.